I have a wonderful electronic invention I want you to see.
It looks something like you.
So this could be one of the most valuable videos that you watch. We're going to clearly break down and explain exactly what the drone code is. We're going to show you what it means, how it works, and what you can and can't do with your drone. So the drone code has been developed by the UK Civil Aviation Authority, and it's their way of trying to simplify the main rules that you need to be aware of. With this though, there still seems to be a lot of confusion around them. To help clarify, I'm going to take you through each rule individually, break them down and explain exactly what they mean. One final note is that the drone code is law. They aren't just advisory notices, so you need to follow them. So let's get started with the first rule. Number one, always keep your drone in sight. This allows you to see and avoid other things whilst flying. This rule is essentially saying you need to keep a clear view between the pilot's eyes and the drone. Nothing can come between you. Doing this, you can make sure that you can clearly see how to fly the drone, and also you are aware of your surroundings if anything comes in that you need to be aware of. So an example of what you can't do is flying your drone around a building. If you lose sight of your drone as it goes behind the building, you have breached the rule. So to do this shot, you could fly above the building and capture that 360 degree view, maintaining a constant view. And rule number two, it's against the law to fly your drone over 400 feet, 120 meters. Now this just reduces the likelihood of conflict with a manned aircraft. So this is one of the simplest rules, but it's one that tends to come up all the time and people tend to get very confused with it. So possibly the best way to visualize this rule is imagine a piece of string 400 foot long tied to the bottom of your drone. At the other end, that's anchored to the surface of the earth. You can't go higher than 400 feet. If you're on a hill, for example, you can fly at the top of that hill. You've got 400 feet from the top of that. That's not a problem at all. If you start to fly out, that hill then drops away. You need to follow that curvature. You need to lower your drone down. Imagine that string is 400 foot, but that string can turn, so it's the closest point to the surface of the earth. So you might be flying at the coast, you might be flying over a cliff. You can fly above that cliff, you've got 400 foot, that's not a problem. If you then think of that piece of string, as you fly over the cliff edge, that string is no longer attached to the ground. But your string can turn like that, it doesn't have to be vertical. As you move out, it's just the closest point to the surface of the earth. Now, rule number three, every time you fly, follow the manufacturer's instructions for your specific drone. So this just keeps your drone safe and the people around you safe. By understanding the capabilities and limitations of your drone, you know when you can and can't fly it. And on to number four, keep the right distance from people and property. For people and properties, you need to stay a minimum of 150 foot, that's 50 meters away. For crowds and built-up areas, that's 500 foot or 150 meters, and don't overfly. So this is one that confuses most people that look at the drone code. So to help out, we're going to go through and break this down. So to start with, we're going to talk about what safe distance actually means. Now, the distances are always referring to the distance of your drone away from people and properties, not the pilot. Imagine your drone is in the center of a bubble. You can't fly your drone or your bubble closer than 50 meters or 150 meters. If you've flown closer, imagine that bubble is gonna pop. So you've flown closer than you should have. And the second part of this rule that confuses a lot of people is, what does built up area actually mean? Well, built up areas are areas that are populated. They might have a lot of movement with cars or people. They could be residential, they could be villages, towns, cities. It could be an industrial estate as well. If you're flying close to any of these, you need to stay a minimum safe distance of 150 meters away. If you're unsure whether you're flying near a built-up area or not, just apply some common sense and stay 150 meters away. That way, you're not going to have any problems. So number five, you are responsible for each flight and legal responsibility lies with you. Failure to fly responsibly could result in criminal prosecution. So number five is a pretty simple one. It's essentially saying that the drone pilot is responsible legally for the actions of that drone. If you're doing something you shouldn't be with your drone, or you're flying somewhere you shouldn't be, legal responsibility lies with the pilot, and it's the pilot that could be prosecuted. And finally, number six, Stay well away from aircraft, airports and airfields. It's illegal to fly your drone within an airport's flight restriction zone without permission. As of March 2019, these FRZs cover a radius of 2 or 2.5 nautical miles and then cover 5 kilometres by 1 kilometre starting from the threshold at the end of each of the airfield's runways. These zones also extend up to a height of 2,000 feet. This means it's illegal to fly a drone within these FRZs unless you have permission from air traffic control at the airport or, if air traffic control is not operational, from the airport itself. The key takeaway for this rule is that it's illegal to fly your drone within a flight restriction zone without permission. Simple as that. So the wording to this rule can seem quite confusing and the graphic does look quite complex. But essentially all you need to check is if you are in the zone, you can't fly. If you're out of the zone, then you can. These zones are marked on maps, so it's easy to understand and check quite quickly. Now we are going to show you exactly how to check these in another video. So hopefully that's helped clarify exactly what the drone code is and what each of the rules actually means. But if you have any questions, just comment below.